INS Vikrant, India's indigenous aircraft carrier, has achieved full operational status after successfully completing its final operational clearance this year. Vice Admiral V. Srinivas, the Flag Officer Commanding-in-Chief of the Southern Naval Command, confirmed this achievement during a media briefing aboard the INS Shardul in Kochi. He explained that the completion of various trials and the ship's integration into the fleet had enabled INS Vikrant to become fully operational and be deployed under the Western Fleet. Srinivas highlighted that the ship, which serves as a symbol of national pride, is now capable of performing all operations and commitments required by the Indian Navy. Commissioned by Prime Minister Narendra Modi in 2022, the INS Vikrant is part of the Western Naval Command and is ready for naval assignments. The ship, designed by the Indian Navy's Warship Design Bureau and built by Cochin Shipyard Limited, is the largest ever constructed in India's maritime history. With advanced automation features, it has around 2,200 compartments, housing a crew of 1,600 personnel, including women officers and sailors. The INS Vikrant is equipped to operate a diverse air wing, including MiG-29K fighter jets, CAM-31 helicopters, MH-60 are multirole helicopters, and indigenously produced advanced light helicopters and light combat aircraft. The government has approved the construction of two indigenously designed nuclear attack submarines, or SSNs, with contracts expected to be signed next month for the procurement of 26 naval variants of Rafale jets and 3 Scorpene submarines, according to Navy Chief Admiral Dinesh Tripathi. Speaking ahead of Navy Day, Admiral Tripathi stated that the Indian Navy is closely monitoring Chinese naval activities in the Indian Ocean and expressed surprise at the growth of the Pakistan Navy despite its economic challenges. He noted that the 8 new submarines being built for Pakistan would significantly enhance its combat capabilities. The Navy chief emphasized that India is adjusting its strategy to prevent any encroachments on its operational areas and affirmed the Navy's preparedness to tackle threats from neighboring countries. He also mentioned that India plans to induct around 95 ships over the next decade, focusing on building a future-ready naval force by 2047 to strengthen India's maritime power and ensure credible deterrence. Regarding the approval to build 2 nuclear attack submarines, Admiral Tripathi stated that the first SSN is expected to be commissioned by 2036-37, with the second following 2 years later. These submarines will significantly enhance the Navy's capabilities. He also confirmed that the contracts for the Rafale jets and Scorpene submarines should be finalized by next month, noting that the formalities for both deals are in progress. The Rafale jets, primarily for deployment on the INS Vikrant, were approved in July of the previous year, along with the procurement of the 3 Scorpene submarines. Dr. Jeet Suthish Reddy, the former chief of DRDO, confirmed that the rollout of the Tejas Mk2 fighter jet is on track, with plans for its unveiling in September-October 2025. This announcement, made at the Emerging Technologies in Defense event in Chennai, highlights a significant step in India's indigenous defense aviation program. The Tejas Mk2 is part of the next generation of the light combat aircraft program, designed to bridge the gap between the existing Tejas Mki and Mkj variants and the upcoming 5th-generation Advanced Medium Combat Aircraft, AMCA. Hindustan Aeronautics Limited intends to conduct the first flight of the Tejas Mk2 before March 2026, following taxi trials that will begin soon after the rollout. These trials, expected to last 3 to 4 months, will thoroughly test the aircraft's systems before its maiden flight. The Tejas Mk2 is set to play a key role in modernizing the Indian Air Force fleet, especially as aging aircraft like the Jaguar, MiG-29, and Mirage 2000 approach retirement. The Mk2 is expected to fill the medium-weight fighter gap within the IAF. The aircraft is equipped with advanced operational flexibility, capable of carrying a variety of weapons, including beyond-visual-range missiles, precision-guided munitions, and air-to-ground weaponry. Its cutting-edge avionics and enhanced electronic warfare capabilities are expected to provide the IAF with a significant technological advantage in complex operational scenarios. armored vehicles Nigam Limited AVNL, has announced plans to form a joint venture with Russian defense firms Rosoborn Export and High Precision Systems to develop and produce a new light tank for the Indian Army. This initiative is aimed at fulfilling the Army's requirement for 295 light tanks under the Make IT Indigenous Procurement Program. The joint venture will be majority controlled by AVNL and India Opto Limited, ensuring Indian oversight of the project. The collaboration will leverage Russia's expertise in light tank design, particularly the Spread SD, as a potential base for the new vehicle. This development puts the joint venture in direct competition with the indigenously developed Zorwar light tank, a project between the Defense Research and Development Organization and Larsen & Toubro, L&T. The Zorwar, which emphasizes modularity and indigenous systems, has already received an initial order of 59 units, with user trials set to be completed by 2027. The introduction of the Russian-backed light tank raises a key decision for the Indian Army, whether to expand investment in the Zorwar or diversify its fleet by incorporating the Spread SD-inspired model. While the Indian Army has shown a preference for indigenous platforms, the Russian alternative with proven technology could influence procurement choices. Critics of diversification warn that operating multiple light tank types could complicate logistics, maintenance, and training. The need for light tanks is driven by the Army's requirement for a rapidly deployable force with high mobility and firepower, particularly for operations in challenging terrains along India's northern borders, where heavier main battle tanks are less effective. Navantia, the Spanish shipbuilding giant, has emphasized that the S-80-class submarine it is offering for India's Project 75I is not a modified export version, but the exact model used by the Spanish Navy. This statement is aimed at strengthening Navantia's position in India's quest for advanced conventional submarines with next-generation capabilities. The S-80-class, currently in service with Spain, is a new generation of non-nuclear submarines designed for extended missions and high-performance operations. Navantia has assured that the submarines offered to India will be equipped with all the systems used by the Spanish Navy, without any downgrades or omissions, which is significant given that export versions of military equipment are often stripped of advanced technologies. Project 75I seeks to acquire 6 advanced conventional submarines with air-independent propulsion or AIP, to enhance India's naval capabilities. This initiative is part of India's strategic partnership model, which encourages collaboration with foreign original equipment manufacturers or OEMs to boost domestic submarine manufacturing. Navantia is one of the shortlisted OEMs, and if selected, it will transfer technology and provide expertise to ensure the submarines are built in India, aligning with India's Atmanirbhar Bharat. The S-80 class is equipped with AIP, which allows for extended submersion and enhances stealth and endurance, crucial for operations in the Indian Ocean region. It has a range of 8,000 nautical miles, advanced sonar and combat systems, and can carry various weapons, including torpedoes and cruise missiles. Its design also emphasizes crew comfort and incorporates automation to ease long deployments. By offering the full capabilities of the S-80 class and committing to technology transfer, Navantia strengthens its case for India's Project 75I, which could significantly enhance India's underwater capabilities and support its growing indigenous defense industry. That's all from YKS Team for now. If you like the information, then please do share and give a like. You can also become our channel member and support our work. Thanks for watching.